Hello, in this video I'm gonna show you the Circuit Mess Synthia. Although they call it a synth, it's actually a sampler and a sequencer. Circuit Mess sent me this, they're not paying me anything, so I'll give you my honest review. The Synthia is a DIY kit, it comes with their subscription plan. And it's really fun for beginners because you can assemble yourself, it's pretty easy to assemble, and you can learn about coding and electronics. And of course, have fun with a sequencer and a sampler. So let's see how to assemble and how to use the Synthia. So Circuit Mess sent me Synthia, which is a DIY synthesizer. Actually, I figured out that's not really a synthesizer, but a sampler, but a really cool one with the sequencer. So here you have some sort of introduction to what a synthesizer is, effects, some cool beginner stuff, the PCB, which comes with instructions to use the synth, components, more components, and a USB cable. So let's see if we can figure this out without looking at the instructions, because who cares about instructions? So guess where this goes? Okay, now the tactile buttons. So it's really easy to solder. The pads are very big, so good if you're a beginner. Let's snap the rotor encoders. Oops, I did a mistake. One of the pins didn't go through and I already soldered the others. That's bad. Let's see if I can fix it. Well, it's not really snapped there, but it's touching, so if I put a drop of solder there, it might work. Either way, they sent me an assembled one, so if this doesn't work, I have a backup. Oh, another mistake. But it's okay now. Trying to not lose all the parts here. Okay, so it seems that's all we have to solder. So let's put in the enclosure. Okay, so I guess that's the right screw. Looks like. And well, I think I am missing one screw. Oh no, I just found it. Huh? Okay, so let's snap this here. Cool. Now what I guess we do is adding another spacer here. And then the last part here should be like this. Let's add the rubber feet. Okay, and I forgot to connect the speaker. Of course, why do it the easy way if I can do it in the harder way, okay? And waste a bunch of time. So, how do we do this? Speaker goes here. Do we just glue it there? I guess so. Let's do it. No, too bad. Okay, a little better. That's a nice idea. Let's do that again. There's something wrong, it's not... I don't know if I'm doing something wrong, but maybe the case is just not high enough as it should. That's fine. Damn it, not the right side. Why so hard to be me? When you see my edit videos, you have no idea of how many things go wrong in my projects, how many mistakes I make. In my videos, I make everything look beautiful and flawless, but I am far from that. I make a lot of mistakes all the time. And if you're gonna build stuff, know that being upset with yourself because of the mistakes you make is something that's gonna be in your daily life. So building stuff can teach you a lot about resilience, but it pays off in the end, hopefully. Okay, so now, of course, I am missing a screw. Well, I lost this screw, but luckily I have other ones here, spare, so that's not a problem. Okay, next step, knobs. And we are done. Oh, and I just found the screw, but screw it. And I think that's all we need. Now we should be able to make some sound. So their USB cable is really, really short. Come on, guys. So I had to get another one, USB-C. Ooh. So it asked me to click on any button.
All right, that registers. Next up for the slot. All right, that's it for me. You can enter this.
Ooh, okay, so. So here's the volume. Okay, so let's see if I know how to use this. Let's just use this speaker just for testing. So here I can move the cursor of my sequencer. So this is like a MIDI sequencer. So you have here the tempos. And so the columns are the tempos and the rows are the tracks. So I can add 1, 2, 3, 4. So. Okay. Whoops. I entered in the sample mode where I can choose the sample, but I don't want that. Okay, track. Oh, the way you delete is pressing 2 times, I guess. Oh, yeah, so. So I have my sequencer ready, so let's see how it sounds. Here you adjust the volume. And here the speed. But you can also record things here because this is a sampler and a sequencer. So if I press and hold, okay, we are in the sequencer mode. Oh no, here's the sample. I don't know what I have done. I added an effect, but I didn't want to. Okay, here's where we can save our sequence. Oh, here we can change the sample. And here, when it's blinking, we can record. And I guess if we hold it and just say something. Woo! I guess you did it. So let's try to come back. How do we do that? Okay, track. Let's try to record another sample. You can move the sequence while playing. The problem is that it seems that you record your sample, but you can't really edit where it starts, so it doesn't sound on time. So I don't know if there's a workaround that, but either way, it's pretty fun. So as you can see, Cynthia is pretty easy and fun to build. You can actually hack Cynthia using their coding blocks, but I didn't really want to learn a new language, so I didn't hack it. Also, there's a way for you to code with the Arduino IDE, but I haven't found much documentation. I tried, I couldn't do it. So if you had any success coding it with the Arduino IDE, please let me know in the comments. So what do I think about it? If you're a nerd like me and you'd like to gift someone, like someone from your family, so they could start learning about electronics, programming, and music, that would be great. I don't think it's a professional instrument, but I think you could take to your friends' gathering and have some fun jamming with it. So what do you think? Would you buy one? Would you gift this to a friend? Let me know in the comments. Also, if you like to build stuff and actually have professional equipment paying very little money on each project, you could build your own MIDI controllers. You can build them very inexpensively and the way you want. If it's something you think you'd like, please check the Nerd Musician Pro course here below. There I'll teach you, even if you have zero experience in electronics or programming, to build any kind of MIDI controller you want. From launch pads, mixers, and crazy art installations. The link is here below. And also don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you didn't do yet. So see you in the next video.